Hey everybody, this is Ted at Inergy. I'm here in Utah. It's February 20th today, and this is my neighborhood, and we got the power company out here, and they are doing some good work for us. They're helping us keep our grid stable. So they got they're doing a pole replacement, but what that has resulted in is that we are out of power for a good 3 hours or so. I'm gonna take you home back into my house and just show you what we're doing in our house with our Kodiak and our Apex to kind of keep things going. Okay guys, so here's the setup I've got going on in the kitchen. So on a long power outage like this, where it could go up to 8 hours, I'm a little bit worried about my food. And so I do not want all of this to melt, to go to waste. I've got milk, I've got cheese, I've got all kinds of things. I want to keep it going. So I've got my refrigerator hooked into my Apex, and I'll just turn my inverter on, and you will see that I now have power to my refrigerator. And I could also plug in the freezer that we have in the garage and run it, but with freezers, you know, you're making choices at this point. And with a freezer, if I don't touch that thing, it's going to be okay, I think, for, you know, a good long while. So I've got the refrigerator plugged in, and what I've got, you know, I don't expect this to go much longer than 8 hours, but if it does go into the nighttime, I've got some lighting set up where I can use my Inergy base camp chainable LEDs, kind of make the kitchen kind of like the hub of the home, and have light so the kids can do their homework, and so the, you know, everything can keep going. I've got my 30-foot cable running out to 300 watts of solar panels outside, and I'll show you that in just a second. But what the effect of that is, my solar panels, I'm going to show you on a close-up here with my camera. With my solar panels hooked up in some pretty good light outside, you can see them right here, I'm actually charging my battery at 251 watts with 3 solar panels right now. And what that means is, it doesn't matter so much that I didn't have it charged up all the way, which, bad camera work, that I didn't have it charged up, because I'm already up to 59% with some full sunlight. And that'll come and go, because you can see that I've got some clouds coming. That's the beauty of solar panels. It's because when you've got sun outside, you can run things, and you can charge your battery up at the same time. So I love my solar panels. Now, if I wanted to, I could take another cord downstairs to my Wi-Fi router and power my home office and everything. I'm not doing that because I have a Kodiak as well. And so I'm going to show you downstairs what we've got going on with the Kodiak. It's perfect for what I need it to do, and it keeps me going because I do work from home, and I got to have power to my home office. All right, guys, so what we've got here is my utility room. I've got my Kodiak plugged into some stuff here. I've got my USB base camp lighting up my room for me. It's a great, really efficient light. I've got a power strip with my landline receiver and my Wi-Fi router. And you can see my Wi-Fi router is like fully charged up. All my services are running. I've got probably pulling about 31, 32 watts. Right here you can see I've got another cord that's going off into my home office. It's powering my monitor, my laptops, keeping me going today so I can keep working. So everything's working great. I'm really happy, and it is fun having two. And again, I don't have to worry about gas. I don't have to worry about the noise of a generator. My Kodiak is doing awesome for me. Okay, so there you can see my little solar panel cable coming out and leading over to my 300 watt solar panel array. What I've got here is one Inergy Lynx semi-flexible and two Solar Storm. I've got them peaked as well as I can to the sun. And one quick way to do that is to stand in front of your panels and have your shadow cast straight on. Oh, I love you too. And I'm leaving this in. And you'll have your panels peaked ideally to capture as much solar energy as you can get. And as you can see, it's working out pretty great for me. Okay guys, I just want to wrap up by giving you an update here. So you can see that my battery capacity is up to 68%. I'm pulling a net of about 258 watts. That means that I'm pulling all of the power that I'm pulling from here, putting some into the fridge, and that
right there is the net number going into my battery.
So I'm really happy about that. I started off at about 25%, like I said, and I'm up to 69%. So I could be doing even better because I could add two more panels outside. I could have up to 500 watts coming in. I just did 300 today. So I just love the fact that I can take clean energy from the sun and bring it into my home, push it into my battery, and still power all of these devices. I can keep my food cold. If I need to, I can bring my freezer in here and plug it in and power that as well. I can power my kids' laptops and things when they come home from school to do their homework. I can keep our Wi-Fi going. I can stay, you know, we can keep connected. All of our electronic devices. I can even run the dishwasher, or I can run a load or two or three or four of laundry. And it's just awesome to think that I can do all of that with this little compact box. And then the great thing is I can put this in the car and I can take it with us wherever we go. Whatever we want to do, we've got backup power. I can take it to my dad's house if he's got a power outage and I can help him out. So I really love the Apex, and I know you will too, for power outages, for camping, glamping, for off-grid living, whatever you need it for. So if you guys have any questions about anything you've seen here today, please let me know in the comments below, or reach out to us at 877-891-2657, or you can find us at energytech.com, and thanks for tuning in.